Leunig Fragments is a portrait of the well-known cartoonist, artist, poet, provocateur and philosopher Michael Leunig. It explores the man who's now well into his 70s as he faces the enigma of life and death. Well, he's pretty much done that all his life in his art with his weaponized whimsy, as Philip Adams describes it. But the portrait emerging from this film is of a boy who came to grief along the way, emerging as a man who felt lost and alienated from the world, which is the origin of much of his work. His role as black sheep of his family led to a severing of relationships with his parents and siblings. The only member of his family included in the film, his son Sonny, says he sacrificed personal and family life for his profession, and his second wife of 26 years recently separated from him. Mortality hovers over the film as Leunig confronts the death of his friend John Clark and the condition of his former much-loved teacher, Joan Brogdon, who suffered from a stroke. I hope she agreed to be included. The filmmaker Casimir Burgess has reconstructed scenes from Leunig's youth, conducted extensive interviews over a period of years, and talked to people like Adams, Richard Walsh, and others about this enigmatic figure. Burgess had previously directed the rather elusive drama Fell. This is his first feature documentary, and it's been beautifully and painstakingly made. It really does offer great insight into the man behind the cultural icon.
Yes, it is absolutely beautifully made, but it is fragmentary, and it sort of raises all sorts of interesting questions, and there are many questions in it too that just aren't answered or even fully addressed. Why have so many of his family kind of deserted him, or why has he deserted them? Why has his wife left him all those years ago? Why did the early marriages break up? Because he does come over, for all that he's an absolutely charming, whimsical chap, as being a rather sort of difficult man. He's interested, for example, in directing this film himself. Every now and again he'll say, put the camera over there.
Yeah.
He's actually very frail now, and the shots of him as a young man are quite, you know, wonderful because he's a vibrant personality.
And very handsome.
Very handsome. Yeah. He's still interesting looking with the great mane of white hair, but he's very frail. And why did this film, another question, why did it take so long to make? It seems to have taken about 8 years, I think, since the start of filmmaking. Did Leunig stop and say, I don't want to go?
He did. There's that intimation that he has become unavailable to the filmmaker. So,
well, maybe he became unavailable to people in his life. He gives that impression of a man who has become totally obsessed with what's left of a vision in the studio scenes.
Well, I also think that there's a great sadness at the heart of this film. And I think it is a man at a certain point in his life with major regrets. Mm. That alienation from the people that should be theoretically closest to him. And that there's just nothing there. But maybe that emotional closeness is something that's a little bit alien to me.
There's another side to him that comes through as well, which is kind of, again, raises questions. There's the sort of celebrity side of him, the selling side. He loves selling his work and pushing it out there, which seems at odd with the sort of the frail artist figure that he presents himself as being at the same time. And I must say, over the years, I've always admired Leunig's dress sense. I always wanted to dress like him. I wanted to know where he got those fabulous clothes. He always is the most beautifully dressed character you've ever seen. So that's another aspect of Leunig that comes across. He's always beautifully presented in the most superb Italian clothing.
I would never have suspected you of that sort of superficiality.
Well, it's totally true, Margaret. I am far less than what appears.
This film, though, I think has merit and insight, and I think there are a lot of questions in it, but I think in a lot of ways they're answered. I'm going to give this 4 stars.
I'm going to give it 4.5. I liked it more than you, I think, even though it raised so many questions. And one of the things I did love about it especially is the childhood scenes that are recreated. They're absolutely superbly filmed and very touching.
I minded those the most in the film. That's why I'm only giving it 4.
Well, that's why I'm giving it 4.5.
I've never owned a suit in my life. Well, I rang up the guy, the phone number, and I said, look, I don't feel good in a suit. He said, well, if you don't want to wear a suit, don't bother coming. And I said, oh, OK, I won't come. And I was happy not to be there at the grand inauguration.